explains the mission of the gospel, or the mission of the church, in terms of Jesus not only as Savior, but as poor. Jesus the poor. And this is the emphasis of the whole section on the social dimension of the gospel. He wants to take seriously the words of Jesus in the synagogue of Nazareth. The Spirit of God is upon me because He has anointed me to bring glad tidings to whom? To the poor. And Bishop Paul tells us, what is the poor? It's a disposition, he says. It's a disposition. This is the trend in Paul's documents when they talk about the poor in the Gospels or in the Scriptures. They talk about those without rights. The three paradigms of poor poverty in the Scriptures. Three. You can name the three of them if I begin. Orphans, widows, and foreigners. Foreigners. These have no rights. Foreigners going to Israel have no rights during the time of Jesus and before. Children have no rights. They have children. Children and widows have no rights. Their rights refer to the rights of their husbands or their fathers. You see that all over the Scriptures. The men versus the women. The children also versus everybody else. These are the three groups of people whom Jesus loved in a very distinctive way. Bishop Hamilton talked about the Syrophoenician, right? And then the children. Blessed are the children. Be like little children if you want to enter the kingdom of heaven. Be like little children. The widow whose son died, it is to her that through, because of her own prayer, that Jesus raised the son, the only son, to life again. Three categories. All these are poor because lack of human rights. Number two, because they are said to be outside, in the periphery of Israelite life. So the Pope wants to take that gospel, the words of Isaiah the prophet, seriously. I came to give good news to the poor. Towards